Hi, my name is Søren Lundtoft. Today I'm going to show you how you can use the digital catalog as part of our PDX offering to be able to distribute and share product information and assets with your business partners downstream. If we look at the dashboard for PDX right here, you can see that I've added a channel here for Acme Catalog. And this just works like any other channel that you might have in PDX. Let's go to our master data section just real quick and have a look at the products that I have in here. I have a set of headphones here, and I want to assign these products to my digital catalog so I can share them. Let's just select all of our headphones here, and let's go to the top menu on the right and add them to a channel. So as I said, the channel is basically, or the digital catalog is basically just like any other channel in PDX. So you can just select it from the drop-down list here. It's set up as a configure channel with a custom output, so I can control exactly what attributes and what categories are exposed to my suppliers. So let's go and add it to the catalog, and let's assign all of these to a headphone category. I've already set this up, so I should have some categories that match. In this case, we have audio and headphones here. Let's go ahead and add the products to the channel. As you can see, the products are now here, and I can do mappings and transformations just as I can do with any other channel in PDX. So I want to make sure that I have all the information that I use in my master data available in the correct attributes that I want to expose to my suppliers or my end users. Let's go to the grid view. And here we can see all of the attributes that I've configured and set up. These attributes can be different from the ones that you use internally, so you can expose them in a way that makes sense for any business partner that you might have downstream. Let's go ahead and do some mappings here. As you can see, some of these mappings have already been created for me, but there are still mappings here that I need to do. Like, for example, mapping the product description, as you can see here. So this is basically the same process as with any other channel in PDX. Let's map a couple of these others here, activity type, and so on. Let's hit save. As you can see, the main images here are also carried over. This is going to be important in a minute when we go into the digital catalog, where you can see how those images appear in a gallery view. Let's select my products. And just with any other channel in PDX, you can now submit these, and they instantly become available to any business partner you might have downstream. They're now submitted, and I can move to the separate tab I have up here. And this is representing the view that my business partner might have when they go into the digital catalog. There can be multiple catalogs that you expose to a business partner. And you are in complete control over who sees and gets what data. Let's click on the catalog here. And as you can see, all the headphones I just submitted before are now available in a nice gallery view. I can click on any of these to see more details. I can also change languages. I can do filters to find the products that I need. I can even select the category that I want to see. As you can see, the product information I mapped earlier is now available here, and it's available in the data model that I have decided to expose to my business partners downstream. I also have images and assets available, and here we support anything from videos to images and documents that you can preview and then download if you want to. We also have the option as part of the catalog to be able to select products and actually export them into an Excel file directly from within this UI. And finally, we have an option for more advanced business partners to be able to use our API to download these products directly from the catalog. That's all I had for you today. Thank you so much for watching. And if you liked the video, make sure to hit the like button below and subscribe to our channel so don't miss out on any future videos.